You guys can go ahead and just stand like near the edge if you want.
Yeah.
All the way down.
All the way down to the other end. You guys spread out all the way down the other end. Spread out. Good.
See if they can hear me.
You are looking live at Westmont College Olympic Training Facility, where we are waiting for Olympic gold medalist Amy Cochran, apologies, to perform the first ceremonial two laps. Here she is now. Let's give her a round of applause. Amy's technique is on fire. She's really boiling that water. As you can see, she grabs a cookie and puts it in her pocket. Does a great flip turn, coming back. She's like a puppet, her elbows like on a string. Getting good body roll and a good pull from front to back. Brings the hand to the hip and pulls the gun out of the holster. On the way back, she's gonna go ahead and do the backstroke. Keeps her belly on a string, pointing it to the sky. Her head's on a swivel, like her spine is a rod of iron. Keeps her thumbs up all the time, the whole way. Makes a rainbow with her hand and then scoops the gold. Perfect. Let's give it up for Amy. Thank you. Woo! All right, guys, go ahead and bring it down to this end. All right, fantastic. Thanks, Amy. All right, guys, I'd like to welcome you guys back to the Westmont College Olympic Training Facility. Once again, I'm Coach K. This is Coach Kabooling, Coach P, where'd she go? There she is, there's Coach P, and then Coach Dub right here. One thing we want to make sure we reiterate is proper safety when you're getting back into the pool, is sit on the side of the edge, on the edge of the pool, and then go ahead and slide in. Today we're going to start off by reviewing a few things, which is going to include gliding and the wall kick, but today we're going to include side breathing. Instead of just pulling your head out of the water. Then we're also going to go into freestyle like Amy demonstrated, and then bring it back into the backstroke as well. A few things we're going to change up today. We're going to have me. I'm going to be the head coach for China over here in this corner. Coach Peterson's going to be the coach for Australia. Woo! Coach Wingy is going to be the coach for France, and Coach Kabooling is going to be the coach for Brazil.
Yeah.
Okay. But one thing to keep in mind is the coaches that are on your half of the pool will both be giving you feedback the entire time. So make sure you keep eyes and ears open. If at any point the coaches step back into the pool in the center, they are going to be speaking. And likewise, if either the coaches that are out of the water step back this way, we are going to be speaking. One more thing is when we blow the whistle during a drill, we're going to have you guys swim straight back to the wall so that we can continue on to the next part of the lesson. Okay? And Malia, you're going to be switching over to Ben's group because Ben is unable to swim today.
Here we go.
Cool? All right. Moving on.
All righty. If you guys want to take a spot on the lounge chairs, we're going to move into some out of water demonstration or exercises.
We're gonna review real quick.
Show us, you guys remember what we taught you yesterday?
Yeah.
So go ahead and get started whenever you're ready.
From the hip. Good, Mitch.
Good,
Sarah. Getting the bun burners going today. Good job, guys.
That's stuck on my butt.
Very good.
Perfect.
Alrighty, good job, guys.
Excellent.
If you want to flip around, we're going to go into some stroke technique with the freestyle. So maybe I can have you come demonstrate. So Coach K gave you a lot of the cues that we're going to be using today. We're going to start out just doing one arm at a time, and then we'll put both arms together. We'll start off with, we're going to start from the reach position. So the way we want you to visualize this is you're reaching forward. We're going to have you bent at the waist. You're going to be reaching forward as if you're reaching for a cookie out of the cookie jar. Okay? Hands are cupped. You're going to be reaching down. And in this reach, you're going to have your shoulders rotated where they're almost perpendicular to the floor. But you want to keep your eyes facing the ground at all times. Okay? So I'll come over here. I'll back up. Once you've made your full entire reach, you want to make sure you get your fingers into the water first, and you're going to scoop back with a straight arm as if you're scooping sand out of, like at the beach, you're scooping sand to dig a hole, okay? That path that your hand goes through is going to be shaped like a question mark, if that makes sense. So once you've made that incomplete stroke with your arm, you're going to take your thumb, and it's going to go straight to your thigh, okay? And that's the pulling the gun out of the holster. So once your arm comes through in that question mark, your shoulders are rolling back to being parallel with the ground, grab the gun out of the holster, and then your elbow's on a string, as Polo had said. So your elbow's gonna be pointing up, and it's gonna look like you're in a chicken wing position, okay? So from there, you're gonna lead with the hand again, and back to the reach, okay? Does everyone see? So we'll have you guys stand up, bend at the waist, try and get parallel to the ground. Just whatever arm you're more comfortable with, we'll start with that arm and then we'll incorporate both arms. So let's go ahead and do it. So everyone's reaching, starting with the reach, reaching out, rotating those shoulders, getting the shoulder roll, and then you're pulling back with a straight arm, thumb to your thigh, pulling that gun out of the holster, getting your elbow up like it's on a string, getting the chicken wing, and going back out for the reach. Okay? So let's see everybody practice that for a little bit. So that shoulder rotation, that shoulder roll, is on that reach. So when you get all the way out there, your shoulder should be
reaching. So you want to keep your, right? So this doesn't give you any propulsion, right? The
question mark is in the start of the stroke.
Yeah.
And once you're finishing your stroke, it will come through in a straight line.
Saving your shoulder on the other side. It's easier to rotate this way. So, and rather than having to really have flexibility, it kind of gives you a little bit more range of motion.
Yeah, perfect.
Good. Excellent.
Good. I like how you're keeping that
one.
Shoulders
legit,
that's it. This is
going to
be fun.
Okay.
Is your back hurt?
Good.
Is it from the bending over?
No, I
just back problem.
Okay, we're gonna both arms together now. The one constant we want to get across here is Newton's third law. So everything with swimming is equal and opposite. So as one arm is coming back, as you're making that stroke, your other arm is already in that cocked position, ready to come to that reach. So wherever your hands are, they're always going to be equal and opposite in that stroke circle. Okay? So let's put that all together and let's see both hands. Making sure you're getting your shoulder roll. Starting with the elbow up out of the water.
Forward, good. There you go.
Perfect. Yeah.
Good. So
equal and opposite. So where if this hand's here, it's coming out up to there, this hand should be right about there.
Good. Just remember, there's
some more color.
Chicken.
No, you aren't.
I'm set to chicken.
Good.
Good. It'll be natural. Yeah. You get up in here.
Yeah, once we get in the water, it'll all make a lot more sense. Sarah, make sure you keep the elbow high and go straight in the water rather than. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, you don't want to bring the elbow below the wrist.
Does anybody have any questions so far? Anybody struggling with anything?
How's that feel, guys?
Good.
All right.
Good.
Excellent.
Yeah, another way that Lisa was explaining was in the reach, instead of reaching for a cookie, if that doesn't make sense, you want to spear the fish so that hand's jabbing out as fast as it can. Another helpful way.
And that's just below the water. It's not above the water, but it's just below the water.
That's why it helps to keep your hand, your elbow high so that you can get a good angle into the water so you don't have any resistance with your hand. Anything that'll slow you down will or create resistance in the water is going to slow you down just a little bit. So,
another key is you want to make sure you keep your head facing straight down in the pool. When you rotate your shoulders, you just want your shoulders to go. So your shoulder is going to go to your chin. So that's another kind of cue that you could use. You don't want your head turning unless you're taking that side breath, which we're going to teach you, you know, in a little bit. But for right now, we want to keep your heads parallel to the ground, looking straight down. A good example is every lane has a black line in it, and you want to be looking down and be able to see that black line in the lane. So, okay. All right, we're going to switch around, and we're going to do backstroke now. You guys can all take a seat on the lounge chairs. So the key to the backstroke is thumb positioning. So you're starting with your thumb up, and your thumb's always going to stay up. So as you're coming through your stroke, your thumb flips over and stays in the air. And you're coming back, and that backstroke area is going to be in the shape of a question mark. What Colo used was you're drawing a rainbow, and then you're coming down and scooping the gold.
If that doesn't work, another analogy is you're saying, you have a thumbs up, so you're saying it's all good, and then see you later. All good, see you later.
So, the key here, you don't need to create that question mark with your hand. You're creating the question mark with your shoulders. So as you come back and you rotate your shoulders, you're going to come through like a question mark. So that bump is going to be behind you. And then as you rotate back to start your next arm, it straightens out with your body. Okay? So let's see you guys go through that a little bit. Yeah, if you have long arms, you can stand up.
Once again, you try and keep your head facing forward, same concept, that shoulder's going to go towards your chin.
Thumbs up in the front, right? There you go. Out and out. Boom. Back through.
So once again, the Newton's third law comes into play. Arms are always going to be equal and opposite. So go ahead and start using both arms. You're going to want your timing. As this one's coming through with a stroke, okay. This one's already getting ready to make the next one. So if it makes sense, if you're in the water and you're not paddling your arms fast enough, you're not going to go anywhere. So that's also where Newton's first law comes into play with the law of inertia. Something that's moving is going to want to continue moving. Something that stops is going to want to stop. So if you don't continue your strokes in a timely fashion, you're not going to continue moving.
Make sure you guys keep your hands cupped as well, so then you get the most little one. Friction against the water, which will help propel you faster.
Do you get a tread water?
When you come over, it's once you hit the water, you got to make sure you're cupped, definitely. But it's easier if you just go ahead and keep your hand cupped the whole time.
Any questions? Anybody have any questions? All right, so we're going to get into the water.
Yeah, let's do it.
All right.
Hey, I called you.
I was going to call somebody.
In the game? 7 minutes in, dude.
Are you ready?
Oh.
Keep in mind, guys, we're keeping track of spirit points throughout the next 3 class periods.
China, period.
So
let's go, China.
Let's go, China. Keep the spirit up.
Okay, so everyone just get in and stand against the wall, please. So you guys can go ahead and get in, but just stand against the wall.
All right, everyone. We're going to go over gliding right now. And so what can you guys tell me about gliding from last time that you remember?
Arms up by ears.
Good.
hands
head
together.
Slightly down.
Yes, head down and arms together, and have it straight line on your back. Anything else? That's good.
Feet
good
together.
Feet together, yes.
Together.
Nice. Yes. All right, so we're going to review it again. And one thing to notice or remember is inertia, which Dan briefly talked about. Inertia is the resistance of the body to change a motion. So basically, your body wants to stay still unless a force acts against it. So the biggest thing to concentrate on is your push against the wall. A more forceful push will cause your body to move further. But as you come and slow down, because you have no other forces acting against you, or no forces propelling you forward, you're just going to slowly slow down as you come to your finish. So when I blow the whistle, you guys can start and practice gliding again and focus on your straight arms and the straight line and the bump on the front of your body. So you guys can go ahead and start.
Alright, first group up. Oh, wait, okay, go ahead.
No,
you go ahead. You already blew the whistle.
Alright, blew.
Today. So in side breathing, one of the biggest things that we want to go over is the breathing that we talked about last time, is to control your exhale before you come up for the breath, so that you're not trying to take your exhale during your breath. And it's the first thing we want to do in side breathing is to find the side that you're most comfortable with. So the first thing I want to do is try both sides and see if there's a side that feels more comfortable to you. You can practice bilateral breathing, which is switching off sides, or if there's a side that feels more comfortable to you, you can just stick with that side. And in side breathing, what you want to think of is if you're wearing goggles, to keep that lower lens in the water. If you're not wearing goggles, just keep that lower eye in the water. So, Lisa, if I could have you and Amy both come up here to demonstrate as I'm talking about this. So you're keeping that, so you're just bringing half of your face out of the water, as they're showing. Good. A thing that you can think of as you're thinking about this is what's called pirate breathing. So if you think of having an eye patch on that lower eye, you want to keep that eye patch in the water. And when pirates say R, they kind of turn their mouth to the side. It's a funny image, but I want you guys to think of when you're breathing, you breathe as pirates say R. So you're keeping that eye patch in the water, and you're saying, you're breathing like pirates say R. Okay? And another thing you can think of as you're breathing is someone tapped you on the shoulder and you're turning back to look. One common mistake that people make when they side breathe is that after they take the breath, then they want to look forward. That's something we don't want you to do because then that causes your hips to sink down in the water. So as soon as you take your breath, as they are doing, you look right back down at the bottom of the pool. Don't be tempted to look back forward after you take your breath. Okay, so first thing, I want you all to just stand in the pool and just practice. See if there's a side that feels easier to you and just get used to this concept of side breathing, okay? So take a few minutes and practice.
R.
Don't actually say R.
Make sure you guys exhale before you turn your head, so that, that way you're only breathing in when you're on looking to the side. So you get a less time to
breathe. Tell us how to keep that lower eye in the water.
Ball, right?
Very good.
What?
The reason you don't want to lift your head up
is because it's too hard. I mean, I don't know. Can you really see if you can?
What's wrong? Because this is crucial. Water is getting in your
mouth. Okay.
If
it's too hard, they don't do it. Okay.
Do you guys feel comfortable with this Australia?
Very.
We try
very.
This.
Do you guys have any questions? Are you feeling comfortable with this?
Yes.
Okay. We're gonna add something else on to this now. So now what we're gonna do, if I can get all of your attention, we're gonna now take this to the wall kick like we were doing last time. So we're gonna go back to that flutter kick on the wall and we're gonna add in the side breath. What we're also gonna do is we're gonna take those arm movements like we were practicing on the water. So what I want you guys to do is to do practice the flutter kick on the wall, so with those locked out arms, and as you take a breath, practice one arm movement. So remember some of those things that Dan was explaining on the water. So with that reach, just below the water, grab, reaching for that cookie, and then coming, bringing your arm down, that question mark kind of form, reaching for that gun, bringing it up in that chicken kind of form. Amy's gonna demonstrate right here. And then bringing that elbow really high like there's a string attached, and then that follow through back to the wall. And then when you actually take the breath in that arm movement is in that follow through when your elbow is high like there's a string attached, you breathe and it's almost like you're looking through a window. So watch how Amy does it. See when she takes that breath in the arm movement? Can you all see her? So just watch for a few times as when she takes the breath in the arm movement. So she has her flutter kick, she's boiling the water, and she's just doing an arm movement and practicing her breathing. She's practicing bilateral breathing, she's switching off sides. If there was a side that was more comfortable for you, you can just stick to one side. So I want you all to find a spot on the wall. If you need to come to the middle, that's okay too, if there's not enough room in your lane. And why don't you just, why don't we take a few minutes and practice this, okay?
Do you want to come over here for now, switch, but if you find that one side more comfortable, or if you don't need a breath every time, you can stay on one side.
Yeah, they're just guys.
Sure, that's the
Bring your head a little out of the water as you need to take that breath. So how it swells, because you don't want to, you also don't need to swell the water, okay? So just bring your head a little out of the water as you need to. And try to keep your legs.
You got it,
Timmy! All right, Mitch, let's do it.
Uh-oh.
All
right.
Every time I do something on this, I feel like I'm exaggerating something. And then I go to actually swim.
Alex,
and then it's the other way. Like here, my feet are always way too low. I'm actually swimming, my feet are like.
Alright, Malia, will you tell me your flutter kick practice again? So bring your hips up a little bit higher in the water. Good, and then practice an arm movement with it. Good. So it's not a straight arm movement, but it's like bringing your elbow up like this.
All right, guys, we're going to go ahead and move on. What I'm going to want you to do is go ahead. Everybody's going to grab one of these pool buoys. Okay, we're going to move on to swimming down the lane.
I'll get the blue one.
So the whole object of this pool buoy, okay, is it's going to get tucked in underneath your legs. And the higher you can get it, the better. The easier it'll be to keep it between your legs. And what this does is we're trying to eliminate you being able to use your legs at all, okay? And so while you have it here, you're going to be practicing the exact same motions that we've been talking about, right? So it's the reach, scoop the sand, bring the thumb past the thigh, pull the gun out of the holster or chicken wing, and then look through the window and then get another reach, right? And then you're just going to be doing that equal and opposite on both sides, okay? And so now we're using that, and we're going to be swimming halfway down the lane, and just so that we get used to just using our upper body mechanics, right? We isolated the legs last time, so that's all you guys got to use. Now what we're going to do is isolate the arms so that you get used to just using each one individually, and then we're going to combine them afterwards, okay? So let's go ahead and give that a shot.
We'll have Amy demonstrate really quickly.
See, her legs stay in the gliding position, okay? And her upper body does the freestyle stroke. So make sure you keep your toes pointed, legs adducted, keeping it together, and work on the different cues through the freestyle stroke, okay? Let's go ahead and give it a shot.
So we go in there and then
we're gonna swim one person at a time
so
out.
Go as far as me.
Yeah, and then we're gonna wait here and then we're gonna come back.
Okay? It'll keep your hips high though.
Right here, 20-30 degrees.
So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and set the pool buoys back up on the side of the pool over here. Okay? And we're going to try and add everything all together, okay? So you're going to be getting the flutter kick with your stroke, okay? And so what I want you to do is try to keep a count, right, of your strokes. So you go, if you feel more comfortable on the left side or the right, whatever side it is, so you go breath, one stroke, two stroke, three stroke, four. Take your other breath, okay? And if you want to try bilateral breathing, use an odd number. So you would be switching every time you take a breath, okay? So this time what we're going to do is we're going to go all the way down to the other end. You guys are going to be moving a lot faster through the pool, okay? Because now you got your flutter kicks with you. Okay, so try and keep a count. Let's go ahead and try and do three or four so we're not just breathing every time we use our left arm or every time we use our right arm, okay? That count is going to help you stay a little bit more relaxed because you know exactly when that next breath is going to come. All right? All right, first group up. Go ahead.
Hey, is no one using my
goggles? Oh, yeah. I'll go first. I'll go first. For China.
Are the goggles for
China? I think these are
black. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Sure. Yes.
Good, Tim, go. Keep going, keep going. Keep your rhythm. Keep your rhythm, Tim. Kick, 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 kick. You alright?
You're losing, you're bending at the knees. So what that's doing is taking away from your proportion. So if you kick hard and long, and you're gonna be a little bit, you want them to be the same speed as you're doing with the knees, the kicks and the hips, and that's gonna give you more proportion. Because what your hips are doing, they're sinking.
Yeah.
And so when you try to take your breath, you're like, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so try and make sure you get real short, forceful pulls. Okay. Cup the hands, point the toes.
Okay?
Good.
Good. Perfect.
I wish I could be a really good swimmer because swimming is amazing.
I love being in the pool. Right?
Except for that, like,
he's right. Half going like 5 feet.
Let's go ahead and go back. Wolf is impressive.
Yes. Yeah, Mike, have your lane weight and the same thing. Let's have everybody else go back.
Yep.
Once the first person gets about a third of the way, go ahead and start the next person.
All right, you guys can go ahead and start swimming back.
All right, guys, good job. Coach B is going to take over from here.
All right, now we're going to put together the backstroke. So if you remember some of the elements that Dan introduced earlier with the thumbs up, see you later, and then scoop the gold. And one thing also with your body position this time, it's similar to floating in that you act or you can imagine that you have a string attached to your belly button pulling you up, because it's important that you have a flat body. And then with your legs, a little bit different than the flutter kicking, because you can have, it's okay to have a slight bend in your knee, and your ankle is a little bit looser to get the flooding, but you still want to have the boiling water. So, to review that, can someone tell me what you're going to be doing with your arms?
Make a rainbow.
Exactly.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up, rainbow.
See you later.
And with your legs?
Oh, we're scooping out boiling.
Boiling the water? Good. Good. And we're going to have just another quick demonstration of the backstroke. Yeah, just halfway. Her arms are long and she's scooping under the water and the boiling with her feet, and she's keeping the middle of her body up. So you, and here she's going to be coming back. Alright.
There can be a little bit more bend in the knees.
So now you guys have some time to practice the backstroke, and you'll go about the same distance as we did before, just halfway to the pool. And all the coaches will be here to help you with any questions you have.
Is there any questions right now before we begin? So you can begin with a slight push off the wall. So go ahead.
It's go time. Let's go,
bitch. I don't want to be hurt.
Go.
It's going to be, because naturally when you run, your legs go to the same distance as your feet. When you're swimming, you want your feet to just keep going as fast as possible.
Good.
So focus on getting that shoulder rotation still, because you weren't getting any of there. Go ahead and go back, guys.
Going back, getting back to the gym?
Yeah.
And I'll go on the back.
Remember they said make your spine like an iron rod.
What is it?
Butterfly.
Good.
Good.
it to me. Alright. See how it goes.
Put these two strokes together. So what you're going to do is you're going to start off in the backstroke off the wall. You're going to go halfway, and we'll have both coaches at that halfway point so you know when you hit it. Once you've got to that point, you're facing the wall already. Just go straight into your freestyle and come back. That make sense?
No. Okay, backstroke back, freestyle here.
Okay. So there's no turning around involved. All you're doing is here, boom, hit the coach, and then you just flip over and just go. Back, straight back to the wall.
Sweet.
Okay. It's a relay race, but we want to focus a lot on form. So whoever has the best form, and we'll be the judges. We will announce that group as the winner.
It's like the tortoise in the hare. Slow and steady wins the race. Okay. Yes. Work on your form while you're going through the water.
So we can't go until the next person.
Polo will let you know when it starts. Yeah, wait for the next person to hit the wall, and then you
just
jump off. On my whistle.
Wait,
we're
going to
go back to
about. Back to
right
here.
Okay. All the pressure's
three,
on.
3, 2, 1.
So we're going to go one more round. We weren't able to come up with a winner. So let's go one more round.
We're too close for calling.
Too close. It's all about four. On Polo's whistle.
Okay, guys, ready?
What?
Somebody.
2, 1.
Stop.
Let's go back to full time right there. By the way.
Let's go, Tim!
I have my best form yet.
Good form.
Yeah.
Good form. 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 Good form. Nice, Maria.
So we have our winner. We have a split decision. We have for the freestyle. We have, what is this, Australia here for the win.
Yeah.
For the backstroke. We have France.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we have your eggs at the pool. Put all the buoys away. We'll be back to the lawn chairs.
Okay, good, good.
Bye. 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 Bye.
And then gather around here for a quick closure.
It's not that
cold, you bunch of.
I'm not. Bring it back up.
Alright, you guys can just gather right around here. We can have Amy. So we just want to thank our guest Olympian for being with us today. Thank her for spending her time with us. And I want to just ask you guys, as Amy did her demonstrations, did you guys notice anything about her form?
It was so easy.
Smooth.
It
was really fluid, right?
Yes. What about some of the specific things that we talked about today? Some of the cues we used, did you notice any of those things in Amy's form?
Grabbing the gun from the holster.
Good. Good. And what about, as we talked about some of those things on the deck in the beginning when Dan was explaining, did you guys find those things easier or harder once we got into the water today?
Easier
in the water? That's good. Well, all of your forms looked really good today. We really liked watching those, especially in backstroke. I noticed especially in backstroke, your form was really, really good. So we will continue in our next lessons to continue practicing both freestyle and backstroke to really cement those forms in. But you guys did a really great job. Wouldn't you guys agree, coaches?
Yes.
Great job.
Good improvement.
And so we'll introduce some new strokes in the next class period. So come ready to learn some new strokes and to reinforce some of the old strokes that we've been learning. So is there any last questions that you guys have before we leave class today? Great.
How do we get more body heat?
Thank you.
All right, that's all.